Assalamualaikum. On behalf of Serbia School Board and Administration, I welcome you all to our ninth end of year ceremony and graduation. Now I will ask grade 8 graduate students to please walk up the aisle and come and have a seat. We will start with Nora Zamir's Quran recitation for Surah Baqarah, ayahs number 284
and 86. من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة والكافرون هم الظالمون. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم.
O you who have believed, spend from that which we have provided for you before there comes a day in which there is no exchange and no friendship and no intercession. And the disbelievers, they are the wrongdoers. Allah, there is no deity except Him, the ever-living, the sustainer of all existence. Neither drowsiness overtakes him nor sleep. To him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth. Who is it that can intercede him except by his permission? He knows what is presently before them and what will be after them, and they encompass not a thing of his knowledge except for what he wills. His kursi extends over the heavens and the earth, and their preservation tires him not, and he is the most high, the most great. There shall be no compulsion in acceptance of the religion, and the right course has become clear from the wrong. So whoever disbelieves in Tawhid and believes in Allah has grasped the most trustworthy handhold with no break in it, and Allah is hearing and knowing.
Now we have one of our students who graduated with us last year, Nuha Ali. She has a small speech for our students.
Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon everyone. First of all, I would like to take a brief moment to congratulate the 2019 graduating class and tell them you did it. As you all sit here right now, the next chapter of your lives lie ahead of you. You will write the next chapters of your life and it's up to you to make the best decisions. High school is a large, vast world filled with lots of opportunities to learn and engage in the bigger, more challenging world. In Serbia, you were encouraged to do good deeds and follow Islamic teachings with committed teachers and staff constantly guiding and pressuring you towards Iman and Taqwa throughout your path. But in high school, you have to stay firm to your deen. You're probably wondering why I'm putting an emphasis on this right now, because when you ask me to advise you through a speech, you're expecting me to stand here and lecture you on how important it is to get good grades, study, do your work, and maintain a good GPA. But I've seen so many Muslim brothers and sisters in high school who've lost their faith in Islamic identity and chose to engage in un-Islamic behaviors and activities, but yet are successful in their school life. They're gaining this world, but they're losing the hereafter. So I am reminding you that you shouldn't feel ashamed to publicly express your religion. Respect your religion and people will respect you for who you truly are. I remember when I first attended my interview at North Charter and I met with the school director and principal, the two began to speak highly of the expectations they have towards their students. They displayed great attention to their dress code and mentioned that girls are expected to wear a skirt and shirt. Here I spoke out of my silence and told them that my religion had a different dress code that didn't align with theirs. I expected them to say that it was mandatory or to ignore my comment, but to my great surprise, they didn't neglect this. Instead, they complimented on my courage and ability to speak up, and alhamdulillah, this year, I was able to attend school in an abaya, and the principal took time to find and contact an individual who could sew the logo on for me. Furthermore, it was annexed into the school code of conduct that it's permitted for an individual to dress in such fashion for religious purposes. So I once again repeat to you, respect your religion and people will respect you for who you are. You all have been raised and taught in an Islamic environment, so don't change. Remember, this world is filled with good and evil, and the evil you commit will remain with you. As for the good, it will come back to you. So set big goals, aim for success, and strive to make each day, each assignment grade, and each test or exam better than the previous one. Besides, the harder you work for something, the greater you feel when you make achievements. And success only comes to those who work hard persistently. And I know each one of you will do amazing things in the future. Finally, I would like to once again congratulate and wish you all the best of luck. Thank you and assalamu alaikum.
Jazakallah khairin, Nuhar. So I will talk a little bit about the history when I start with the graduating class. Alhamdulillah, now we have 250 students, a staff of 42, alhamdulillah, and I do have a picture of this year's class. So Tarbiyah's class of 2019, we have Angelina Adams, we have Hanan Ali, Maryam Baqir, Nora Zamir, Nada Ali, Sidra Qasim, and Zakaria Adam. So we started the school in 2010 in my house, as all of you know, and two of my own daughters were part of the students who started that school. Alhamdulillah, four of them, with four students to now 250, alhamdulillah. Now Maryam, my oldest daughter, is graduating, alhamdulillah. Angelina was one of our first students who started the summer school with us in 2011. So she has spent a lot of time with us as well. Nora, Hanan, Sidra, they've all spent at least 6 years inside the school with us. So they've been friends with us, they've been part of my family, just like my own children. So it's sad to see them graduating, but alhamdulillah, we are humbled by all their accomplishments, everything that they have achieved. They are independent, mashallah, they are critical thinkers. They have achieved a lot of accomplishments this year for not only themselves but also for the school, and I will share those with you inshallah a little later on. Now I would like Brother Abdul Basit to come up and speak a few words about his homeroom class.
Assalamu alaikum. I'd like to welcome everyone to the 2019 graduation class. And I had the situation, which was sometimes very pleasurable, to be the homeroom teacher for them for 2 years. And I addressed the graduating class with a verse from the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas ta'muruna bil-ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah." Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you're the best of people who have come forth from mankind. And there are certain characteristics that has to be followed up. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas. You're enjoying what is right, you forbid what is wrong, and you believe in Allah. Now, this is from the Quran, and this is something that I try to mention to all of the students. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed his ummah. Okay, but we have to really want to aspire towards that. And time and time and time again, I mentioned that to these students. And at the same time, they have had a lot of accomplishments just in the 2 years that I've been here. not really surprising, because I've worked with Muslim students for some time, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when His barakah comes, this is all we can expect for the highest success. But I have a special thing to mention to this class, with a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, لا يشكر الله من لا يشكر الناس. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it's an authentic hadith, a person does not thank Allah who does not thank the people. And these students, you have to make sure that you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Because what is the very first verse in the Quran? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So we start off by praising and thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's upon you to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to thank your families who have put you in such a good position. Because you have, in California and many places around, LA has a homeless problem. And some of these children are homeless. And close to here, people are homeless. And Allah has blessed you. He has blessed you with good parents that take care of you. And give you the best that you can to have. So this ability didn't just come from yourself. So don't get, too arrogant or cocky about it. Allah has blessed you with this. He has blessed you. He has blessed you with good homes. He has blessed you with good parents, good teachers, and a very caring staff. Okay, so it's upon you to thank them and to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you are indebted to a lot of people. You are indebted to all these people you see in front of you. You are indebted to all these people who have taught you, who came before you. So you owe them a very serious debt. And now to follow up on what Nuha said, so you repay that debt by doing what you're supposed to do and being grateful to the people and showing them their gratitude. And so, again, I'd like to thank all of you parents, okay, for your support and helping and assistance to all of these students. And this is a two-way street. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Jazakallah khair, Brother Abdul Basit, for your words. Now, Sheikh Mukhtar, if you can please come up and share a few words.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. No, I think you guys are sleeping, Today, very nice weather, right? So respond. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Very good. Now I'm so happy. And you can applause, But make sure you don't do that. Who did it? Nancy Pelosi, before Trump. Instead of doing like this, that doesn't make sense, right? So, it's a beautiful day, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we thank you, especially the parents, mashallah. It's a trust that you have put on us to teach your kids an Islamic way, and the way that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all of you. It's very amazing. This is my first year in Tarbiyah school. I have worked with, my college, teachers. And the most important that I, feel happy about, me and Sheikh Tariq and Sheikh Abdul Basit, we are only what? Tell me. Only what? Man, and the, among the staff. So we are lucky. And so great people, to work with. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We thank all of you. And before I deliver something, I would like to say very simple Arab. In Arabic language, when you have a sentence, you can analyze it, Like fi'il, fa'il, wal maf'ul, and so on. So I would like to share, a very simple thing for you here. And those who speak Arabic, they will laugh a little bit, inshallah. So, Because today is a joy, right? You have to enjoy, right? Don't make face peace. You know, smile. تَبَسُّمُكَ فِي وَجْهِ أَخِيكَ مَا هُوَ صَدَقَةٌ. Right, listen. سَأَلَ أُسْتَاذٌ تِلْمِيذَهُ مَا إِعْرَاب ضَرَبَ الْأُسْتَاذُ التِلْمِيذ. ما إعراب ضرب الأستاذ التلميذ. Alright. فأجاب التلميذ قائلا ضرب فعل ماضي خطير. You got it? ضرب فعل ماضي خطير. You didn't get it. That's why you are silent. Come on guys. Alright. So والأستاذ فاعل مجرم. فاعل مجرم مو فاعل. لا تزعل يعني مو فاعل. فاعل يعني مجرم. والتلميذ مفعول به مسكين. مسكين الله المستعان. فضرب الأستاذ قائلا فضربه الأستاذ قائلا ضرب فعل ماضي جيء به للتأديب. جيء به للتأديب. Very nice. والأستاذ فاعل مرفوع مرفوع مؤدب. يعني فاعل مرفوع مؤدب. والتلميذ مفعول به لأنه أساء الأدب مع الأستاذ. Very nice, you know. It's a way, if you understand, it's so powerful, nice words, you know, and nice إعراب. You know, in Arabic language, when we have a sentence, we have to break it down to know which one is the verb and then the subject and the complement. So that's why Arabic language is so powerful, right? So now I would like to tell you something really important, you know, and this is the reason, you know, I'm here in Tarbiyah School. We have last year till now we have opened full-time Hifz program, meaning that the kids, you know, will memorize Al-Quran Al-Kareem and understand and reflect upon the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we started it last year and this is the first year. Inshallah, next year will be more joyful and nice, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some of our students, you know, some of them are here and some of them are, you know, busy with their parents, you know, doing something nice. Some of them memorize Al-Quran Al-Kareem from Surah An-Nas until Surah Ash-Shura. It's the first year. We said it's the full time, but the reality is that those students, they are doing, you know, in the school. They have subjects. They have English, math, science, and many subjects. And they are doing their best also to memorize Al-Quran Al-Kareem. So it's kind of full time, but not 100%. But inshallah, since Dr. Amin is here, inshallah, next year we're going to make it full-time HIV program, inshallah ta'ala. So, I call upon all of you, if you want to enroll your child to memorize Al-Quran Al-Kareem, you are most than welcome, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khayran, wa kulla amin wa antum bi khayr, wa istamta'u bi utlatikum al-mubaraka, wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Muhtar. I think everybody can see the picture up. It's for the Science Olympiad for this year, 2018-19. And alhamdulillah, our graduating class, each of that child won a medal for the Science Olympiad for this year. Alhamdulillah. Just some of their pictures that we have taken. So we start with Angelina Adams. Angelina has been part of Tarbiyah School for 8 years, alhamdulillah. She was one of our first enrollments for our summer program in 2011. She has won 4 medals for the Science Olympiad and she won the 2nd place for the Peace Art Competition. She was accepted in many charter schools and she will be headed to MOT Charter. We have Hanan Ali. Hanan has been part of Tarbiyah School for 6 years. She joined us in 3rd grade, moved from New York. This year, Hanan participated in the Science Olympiad and she won a medal. She has also been part of a math league for the state of Delaware and won third place last year. She also got accepted to many charter schools and is headed to MOT Charter. I would like to call Hanan up so she can share a few of her feelings and thoughts with you, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. First off, I would like to start this speech with a thank you to all the teachers that have helped me grow, to my friends who have helped me better myself as a person, and to my family who I would not be here without. I would like to say thank you, and I can't put into words how much I appreciate the impact you have put into my life. It's crazy how just about 6 years old, 6 years ago, I walked into a completely new environment just for it to grow to be my second home. To be honest, I myself, Tarbiyah, my fellow classmates, and the students here have all grown to such a great extent, and I'm happy to say that this place is basically where I've grown up. This year was indescribable for me. We've had many ups and downs, many good memories were made, and I've met a few life-changing personalities. The tough times made us even stronger, alhamdulillah. One thing I've learned is to never give up, and in the face of hardship, always rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. We pushed past the negative things, and I didn't allow it to stop us from being, and we didn't allow it to stop us from being the best we could be. Lastly, to my friends, I would like to say I'm so grateful for you, and I sincerely appreciate the happiness that you have provided me with every day. And to my teachers, thank you for giving the education and support needed to help me grow to be the young adult I've grown to be over the years. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.
Next is my daughter, Maryam Baqir. She has been part of Tarbiyah for the past 9 years. Started in my house in 2010. She participated in the Science Olympiad. She won 2 medals. She was part of the Math League statewide competition. She won 3rd place, both for the poster competition as well as for the regional team. She won the 1st place for the Peace Art competition this year. She was a Geography School B champion, and she represented her class and her school at the Delaware Geography B. She has been accepted to Wilmington Charter, Newark Charter, and MOT Charter. I'm going to wait on her decision, inshallah. So I will have her come up and say a few and share a few thoughts and feelings.
Assalamu alaikum. Nora, Sidra, Netta, Angelina, Hanan, and Zachariah. It has been an honor being your classmate and friend. It's been an honor being with you all since kindergarten, 3rd, 4th, and 6th grade. And I can never thank you enough for being by my side whenever I needed you. Tarbiyah is a home for me, and I can never forget anything here. I was one of Tarbiyah's first students when it started in my house as a home student. It's been a long 9 years and a short 9 years. Long because of the occasional dramatic moments, the early mornings, late night studies, and all the other little pitfalls that hit me in elementary and middle school. Short because of the lifelong friendships, lasting memories, embarrassing moments, and the truly interesting and amazing things we've learned between the occasional bits of drudgery. Before I finish this speech, I would like to give a special thank you to my mother, Dr. Amna, for being there for me, whether I needed her as a mother or principal, and to my father for pushing me through all the challenges that I thought I couldn't accomplish, that I could. Thank you, Dr. Vasa, for being a standing and caring teacher who has always been with us and stood up for us whenever we needed him. Mr. Kimba, I definitely want to thank you because you've done so much for me. You've helped me become a better person. We've had our ups and downs, but you're a teacher that I'll never forget. Sister Aisha, you're a teacher from the beginning, an amazing Arabic teacher that I will always remember for the support and help whenever we needed it. Sister Sarah has been a fun, creative, caring, sciencey, and loving teacher. It was so heartbreaking for me when she left, and she's always been with me and means so much to me, and I can never forget all she's done for me. Sister Rahma has been an outstanding teacher. The first time we met was the substitute for Sister Kimba. Over time, we got to know her more, and now we love her so much. Sheikh Mukhtar is funny and helpful when it comes to the Quran. We've been able to talk to him and tell him anything. He's been a breathtaking person from day one. Sheikh Tark always cracks us up and has helped us learn so much Quran. Sheikh Tark, you're a truly extraordinary person.
Last but not least, I would like to thank all the parents for being there for us since day one of our existence. A huge thank you for everyone. Can we please give them a big round of applause?
Next, we have Nora Zamir. She is our valedictorian as well. Nora has been part of our school for the past 6 years. She joined us in third grade. She moved from New York as well. She has participated in many different activities for the school at the state level and the national level as well. She won 4 Science Olympiad medals, was placed 3rd in the Math League regional team. She won 1st place in the Civics B, 3rd place in the Geography B. She participated in the Ikna Quran competition and was placed 1st. She participated this year, 2019, for the Scripps National Spelling Bee in Washington, D.C. She was part of at least 500 to 600 students who were spelling bee champions in their own schools. She was, mashallah, very humble, very, very confident, and she represented herself and her school very well. Please do give her a round of applause. She was accepted to Wilmington Charter, Newark Charter, and MOT Charter, and she's headed to St. George's. So I would like her to please come up and share some of her thoughts and feelings.
Assalamu alaikum. Who would have thought that the day we turn our tassels would come so quickly? I've been at Tarbiyah since third grade, and I can't imagine a life outside those walls. I'm absolutely thrilled to be here today, but at the same time, I'm disheartened, because I'm glad I'm moving forward, but I want to move forward for the people I've moved this far with. As I leave here, I'm leaving a piece of me behind. Tarbiyah was, is, and will always be my school. The teachers here were, are, and will always be my teachers. My classmates were, are, and will always be my classmates. We were, are, and will always be a family. Nothing can ever change that. If you ask me, I'd say that this squad right here, my squad, has done some pretty amazing things. We competed in Harvard University's Invitational Science Olympiad with 4 of us placing top 10. Each of us won medals at the Delaware State Science Olympiad. Last year, 4 of us won 3rd place in the Math League. Miriam won 1st place in the Peace Art Contest. I won 1st place in the Ignas Quran competition last year. Angelina won 2nd place in the Peace Art Contest. I also competed in the Scripps National Spelling Bee in Washington, D.C., where I tied for 370th place in the national finals out of the 11 million students the competition started out with. For that, I'd like to thank Sister Aisha Al-Hajjar. Thank you for taking time out for me, accompanying me, and helping make Bee Week such a joyous and memorable event. Everyone up here is an outstanding and exceptional individual. May Allah continue to shower His blessings on us throughout our lives. We'll never forget all the 1025s we've gotten from Brother Abu Basit, or how it's so hot that Hanan can see the steam coming out of his ears, or how it's too cold and she can see the icicles falling out of his nose, or how Selena kept us up all night at Harvard, or how we found out that surprisingly, brownies dipped in ranch are delicious. We'll never forget our long games of Uno and Scam, accompanied by elbows and knees, or how Hanan randomly pulls out a mango in the middle of class, or Sidra and the frog on the wall in science class, or 15 becoming a shape, or Patty Ratchetsburg and all of her odd sound effects, or me not having okay in my speech. We'll never forget all the good times we've had with each other. I want to thank Dr. Amna. If it weren't for her, Tarbiyah wouldn't exist today. You've done a wonderful job with this school. To me, you're a role model because of everything you've achieved and all the times you've gone the extra mile for us, treating us like we were your own. I also want to thank every single teacher here, because the teachers at Tarbiyah don't teach for the income, they teach for the outcome. Nothing I say will ever thank you enough for all that you've done. I want to thank my family for everything they've done, especially my aunt and my cousins, Bilkis, Asiya, Hasib, and Nurzina, who have given me unconditional love and support through my entire life. I couldn't have gotten through this without you. I want to thank my brother, Nuaim, because of whom I had to be locked in my room to avoid being attacked, which increased my study time. I want to thank my grandmother, who literally since day one has looked out for me and did her best to make the road ahead of me smoother. I also want to thank my grandfather, who I really wish could have been here today. He's always guided us through life, giving the most heartfelt and eye-opening advice. To the six of us, you're the best grandparents in the world. Now, for someone words cannot express my love for. The person who I wouldn't be here today if it weren't for her. The person that I've been able to count on forever. The person that's been the reason of my smiles. My mother. I love you, Mommy. Thank you for being there to listen to everything I had to say, to help me, to take care of me, to nurture me. You can't choose your mom, but if you could, I choose you. You're the best mother a girl could ask for. May every tear that has ever fallen from your eyes become a river for you and Jannah. May Allah grant you the best in this life and the hereafter, and may He grant you a long and healthy life. Now it's time to talk about us. We're leaving. We're going to be walking through the halls of a school we've never been to before, with people we've never seen before, being taught by teachers we've never been taught by before. It's time to step out of our comfort zone. We grew up together, and at first, I honestly didn't think it would be this hard to leave. I want to leave you all with some advice. In life, we have to make choices. We can choose to be like a carrot or to be like a coffee bean. When a carrot is put into boiling water, it changes. It gets soft. When a coffee bean is put in boiling water, it changes the water. Change the world. Don't let the world change you. Never lose sight of who you are. Don't let people convince you that you are anything but phenomenal, because I'm telling you, from the time that I've known you, each and every one of you has the ability to change the world. But that's only if you don't allow people's negativity to influence you. A wise person once said, never explain yourself to anyone, because the one who likes you would not need it, and the one who dislikes you wouldn't believe it. Figure out what you want to do and follow the path to get there. But at the same time, don't forget the reason that you're here, to worship Allah. Worship comes in many different shapes and sizes, besides the obvious, praying. Always make your ultimate goal to please Allah, and no matter where you want to go in life, we should all strive to end up in the same place, paradise. I'm going to say it again. Tarbiyah was, is, and will always be my school. The teachers here were, are, and will always be my teachers. My classmates were, are, and will always be my classmates. We were, are, and will always be a family. Nothing can ever change that. Always be content with the provisions Allah has given you, because whatever reaches you was never meant to miss you, and whatever misses you was never meant to reach you. No matter where we choose to go in life, inshallah our paths will cross again in Jannah. We made it top-notch, Tarbiyans. We're graduating. Congratulations to us, the class of 2019.
JazakAllah khair for your words, Mother. I think she made all of us cry. Next is Nada Ali. Nada has been part of Tarbiyah School for 5 years. This year she participated in the Science Olympiad and she won a medal. She is headed to Newark Charter. Next is Sidra Qasim. Sidra has been part of Tarbiyah School for 6 years as well. She came to us in third grade. She has won 3 medals for the Science Olympiad, 3rd place for the Math League statewide, 2nd place for the Civics B, and 3rd place for the Delaware State's Math League poster contest. She was accepted to Wilmington Charter and MOT Charter, and she's headed to MOT Charter, inshallah. Last but not least, right, Zakaria. He's humorous, mashallah, has been part of Tarbiyah School for 2 years. He participated in the Science Olympiad this year and he won a medal. He is headed to MOT Charter. Now I would like all of you to stand up, please, and we'll move your tassels from right to left. And we have our class of 2019. I would like their parents to stand up, or their family members, whoever have come in, to please stand up. Grandmas have to stand up too. You have to keep standing, sorry. We have some medals for you guys, inshallah.
We have honor roll for Sidra Kasim and Nora Zamir. We have AB honor roll for Angelina Adams, Hanan Ali, Mariam Bakir, and Sidra Kasim. Reading excellence to Nora, Sidra, Hanan. Character to Sidra. Art award to Hanan, Mariam, Nada, Angelina, and Nora. Quran award to Hanan, Mariam, Nada, Nora, Sidra, Angelina, and Zakaria. Arabic award to Angelina, Hanan, Nada, Mariam, Sidra, Nora, Zakaria.
Zakaria, please. I like that phrase she said about the income and the outcome, so I'm letting you know I'm going to use that one. I'm going to use that one. Yes, I like that. Angelina, please. Here you go. Don't want to break it. Nada Ali. Nada, please. This is Mariam. She is the Joker. Hanan. Hanan will keep the class very, very lively between her and Mariam. Yes, now I'm just quiet. Okay, and this is for Sidra. You have big hands, Sidra. You have a lot here. Okay. They also have certificates, but I will give them to you. You want to know? Okay, you have certificates ready for you? And then? Those are all for her. Mariam? Mariam? Nora? These are the certificates that were read off. Sidra? Nada? And Zakaria. And Angelina.
Sheikh Tariq to please come up and make a dua for them.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, make dua for our sons and for our daughter. You have to say Ameen loudly, okay? اللهم وفق أبنائنا وبناتنا، اللهم وفق أبنائنا وبناتنا، اللهم وفق أبنائنا وبناتنا، اللهم أنر بالعلم قلوبهم وأنر بالعلم بصائرهم وأنر بالعلم عقولهم، اللهم اكتب لهم النجاح والفلاح في الدنيا والآخرة، اللهم اكتب لهم النجاح والفلاح في الدنيا والآخرة، اللهم حقق آمالهم، اللهم حقق آمالهم، اللهم حقق آمالهم، وحقق آمالنا فيهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشرح صدورهم ويسر أمورهم، واجعلهم نبتة طيبة لعودة هذه الأمة لخيريتها يا رب العالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد.